And so I now present to you the recipient of Doc NYC's Leading Light Award, Chi-Hui Young.
Thank you, Marsha, for that introduction. Your words mean a lot to me. I think she's probably coming around this way. But Marsha, you know, you're someone that I admire and respect, both for the work that you're doing at Firelight, but also for the choices you've made over the course of your career that have built your analysis and your influence. So thank you, Marsha. And hi, everyone. Good afternoon. It's great to see everyone here in person. Big thanks to Tom and Doc NYC. And excuse me while I put this thing back on my face. You know, it's an honor to receive this award, you know, in particular because it's recognition from colleagues and peers from across the documentary field. And there's so many folks in the field whom I have such high esteem for and are doing committed work in many different areas, you know, critics, curators, nonprofit leaders, funders, and archivists, and several in this room whom I nominated for this award. And so to be acknowledged in this context is really meaningful, so thank you. I also want to appreciate the many teams and co-conspirators that I have built and learned with over the years. You know, the work that we do to allow documentary to do its work, you know, it's iterative, it takes time, and it needs collaboration. And I would like to accept this award on behalf of the team that I currently work with at the Ford Foundation in its Creativity and Free Expression and Just Films teams, Margaret Morton, John Goff, Suzanne Shea, Theo Torre de Castro, and Laurence Martineau. I also want to thank my long-term mentor, Linda Blackaby, who, you know, starting with my very first job many years ago at the San Francisco Asian American Film Festival, and since has so generously opened her world to me and always brings it back to what is just. And, you know, that mentorship and that guidance, you know, set the path from the very start. And, you know, just a few musings on the occasion of today. You know, what invigorates me about working with documentary is the endless possibilities of what it can be and the political and ethical necessity for documentary to ruminate on itself and expand its forms. And, you know, this is for a lot of reasons. You know, one, because documentary's roots are in, you know, colonial ethnography. But also because documentary demands to be accountable to the world around us. And this as a space of creativity I find so exciting. You know, I think about documentary as Marsha mentioned, in its essence, a negotiation of power, you know, relational, political, representational. And the challenge I think facing filmmakers is to be guided by an ethics and an aesthetics that can negotiate this for their particular context. To, as Beckett said, find a form that accommodates the mess. You know, power is always shifting. The mess of this world is getting messier. And I just find it's always thrilling to see how someone has figured this out for themselves. And it never gets old because it's never the same. So I have the great privilege at the Ford Foundation of being able to think about these questions every day and to support filmmakers, leaders, thinkers, and artists who are experimenting with them. And I can't think of more exciting work to be doing, especially now, and in conversation with many of you here. So thank you again, and stay safe. Thanks.